Hi guys, as a part of this video, I'm going to talk about Jira, and this video is going to be my on the new playlist called as Jira. So let's get started. Jira tool is used for planning, tracking and defect tracking tool. Because it is used for planning, tracking and defect tracking tool, it is called as project management tool. As the name suggests, it is the project management tool which is used to manage your project. When I say that it is used to manage the project, I mean it is used to plan the project, track the project and also to defect tracking. Because of that reason, it is called as project management tool. Many companies in India or all over this world, wherever they are following agile model, in order to achieve their software development lifecycle, they are following this famously used project management tool, Jira. So this video is all about that. When I say that Jira is used for planning, I mean that Jira is used for planning what we need to develop and what we need to test. When I say Jira is used for tracking, I mean that to track the task on which status they are in, whether they are in the phase of requirement collection or whether they are in the phase of development or whether they are into the phase of testing or whether they have been deployed into the production. And the third word that I used here was to defect tracking. You guys must be aware of that. What is defect tracking? Now defect tracking is nothing but, now just to know that for which task which bug is assigned or for which task which bug is raised, how they are linked to each other. So for that reason we say that your Jira is used for planning, tracking and defect tracking, and just because it has a capability to perform all these three functions, it is called as project management tool. Jira has certain key features, and some of the key features of Jira are: it is used to track what developer and testers are working on. If my developer and testers are working on a particular task, what is the status of that particular task? Whether the task is in the progress, or whether the task is QA complete or dev complete or dev in progress or QA in the progress. With the help of Jira, we can identify the priority of each particular task. With the help of Jira, we can track that how much time that my developer and tester can take to complete their particular task in the form of user stories. With the help of Jira, we can easily find out that how many tasks we are working on in a particular sprint. And with the help of Jira itself, we can find out that how many tasks we are going to deliver to the customer or how many features we are going to deliver it to the customer at the end of the particular sprint. With the help of Jira, we can identify that if we have taken 5 tasks in the current sprint, if we are able to give only 3 tasks to the customer, that means 2 tasks are still pending which can go to my next sprint. Jira manages that. How I will teach that in my next video, don't have to worry. With the help of Jira, we can identify that how many tasks are there in my bug bucket. With the help of Jira, we can identify that how many tasks are there in my product backlog. And how many tasks that are there in the product backlog, I can add it to my next sprint based on the priority. With the help of Jira, I can do my bug tracking. With the help of Jira, I can do my documentation, any kind of documentation, I can do that using Jira. With the help of Jira, I can do my sprint planning, and with the help of Jira, I can do my sprint retrospective meeting. To conclude, I just want to say that with the help of Jira, your manager can track off each and every task that your developer and testers are working on. You cannot expect your manager to run behind each and every person just to know the status of the task, whether it is completed or not. So with the help of Jira, wherever you are, you can track off each employee what exactly the task he is working on, what exactly the status of that particular task. So Jira is used for that. To manage all work across company, we follow and use Jira. To take any approval or any kind of work within the organization, we use Jira in the form of creating the task and taking the approval of the manager within the Jira and then proceeding further. So this was all about Jira. Now the question arises, who are the exactly people who will be using it? So your manager, let's assume that he is a scrum master, or let's say that your manager can use your Jira to track of the task that you guys are working on. Your scrum master is the person who will be responsible for creating your product backlog, creating your sprint, creating which all task needs to be assigned to which particular developer, assigning the user story of each particular task by your developer, by your tester, making sure that out of 5 tasks that we have kept in the particular sprint, whether we are able to deliver that particular task to the customer or not. It is also used by developer to change the status of the task, whether he is still doing the task or it is really completed from his side. It is used by the tester to make sure that he has picked what developer gave him in the form of dev complete. It is also used by tester to make any particular task mark it as QA complete. Again, it is used by tester in the form of documentation of anything, maybe your test scenarios or test cases or test planning. Every documentation we can make use of our Jira. To write our HLD, LLD, CRS, SRS, we can use of our Jira by anyone in the organization. It may be architect, it may be developer, it may be tester. I tried my best to make you guys understand what exactly is Jira, what are the functionality and what are the features of Jira. I tried my best to make you guys understand in this particular video. But you guys don't have to worry. In my next video, I'm going to show you practically how Jira looks like and how to perform the different functions that I have spoken in this particular video. So you guys don't have to worry about anything. I hope this video was useful. In case yes, please give a big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, Software Testing by MGT, and please share this video with your needy friends. In case you have any kind of doubt, put out all your doubt in the comment section. Thank you guys. See you in the next video.